Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson, let's look at how we can make our left hand chord playing a lot more richer, a lot more unique sounding, and to give it a very dense texture, right? Adding a lot more color and flavor to your music, and more importantly, which a lot of piano players face the issue quite often, is we get away from that usual muddy sound which is played in our left hand, right? For example, if I play an F major chord, this may not be a great way to play an F major. It's not a very clean way because the frequencies are clashing with each other. They are very close to each other in the lower registers of the piano. So what we end up normally doing on the keyboard to play chords professionally is we take the chord to the right hand. Because naturally our right hand is in and around middle C, and anything here will always work well with the music we play. So naturally you don't want to play too many chords in the left hand, voiced as chords, because it's going to clash with the other musicians. Naturally, to compensate for that, a piano player would play the chords here in the right, this is F major, and play the root note in the left hand, that's F. So this is a nice sound. The challenge with this approach is that the chords occupy everything you're going to do in the right hand. In other words, you can't really play a melody while playing the harmony and the bass note. So we need to develop a way to play the full chord, the whole chord, in just the left hand, and then it frees up space for our right hand to do stuff. The first thing I'd like you to learn is the 10th interval, which is important for both the major and the minor chord, which we use very often. Let's find the 10th interval together. So I'm building it with respect to F. Now the 10th interval is very simple. It's nothing but a third played one octave higher. So if I take my F, the normal third would be A, but since it's played in the left hand, creates a very muddy, conflicting environment, so I will prefer to play the A up there. So in order to play these 10th intervals, your hands may need to be a bit wide in order to deal with that, but there are a lot of ways you could get around that. One way is with the sustain pedal. You could play the root, leave your hand, and then play the 10th. Let's do that again. Root. So I've left my hand and I've played the 10th there. But some of you who have wider hands, probably even wider than mine, I don't consider my hand width to be that wide to begin with. So you could play like this. You could actually play them together. So if you have wider hands, play it together. If you are not able to get this stretch, hold down your pedal, the sustain pedal, sound lingers, and then you go there to play the 10th. Let's do that together. That's your 10th interval. And then you also have a minor 10th, which is the minor third. And where does the minor chord happen? In a minor chord. So what will be the minor third with respect to F? A flat. Again, muddy there. So we play it higher. Again, it's quite a stretch. So if you can't stretch, use the pedal and jump, right? So pedal becomes a very important feature for your piano playing. So if you don't have a pedal, you might want to consider getting one, right? Now we've got the root and we've got the minor third, or we got the major third. Now we need to fit in the middle note. What is the middle note? The remaining note of the chord, right? What is the remaining note now? The fifth. So we have the root, the third or the 10th, and the middle note will be the 5th, which is C. So I have to play C here. I can use my middle finger to play C, or I can use my index finger to play C. And there you have it. You have a very crystal clear and rich sounding texture of the F major chord. Right? And it doesn't clash. In fact, it's so rich sounding that right now it sounds good even without the right hand. You can just use this as an accompaniment technique and chill out with your right hand for a bit, or maybe focus on a melody line which you could sing, right? So I'm playing it right now in an arpeggio, so you could consider just going up and down with the set of notes. I like that low note, middle note, high note back to the middle note, or do it in sixes. You've heard the Bach cello suite, which uses this exact voicing, right? So you go maybe a minor. Let's go back to the other arpeggio pattern, right? If you ask me, this is full enough, right? Yes, you could add variety in the right hand, but now if you think about it, you set the platform for a melodic objective in the right hand. So your right hand can now exclusively focus on the melody line. And this lesson is not really about the right hand, right? I've done a lot of other videos which you could watch, which focus on melody playing and melody building. But for this lesson, we are just going to deal with the left hand. So get this voicing going really well. Let's recap. Root, fifth, and the higher tenth, or the higher third. F major, F minor. And we also call this as spread voicing. So a great way to actually form this with another chord, or with any chord in general, is write down the chord, the triad, in a circle, F, A, C. And normally when we build piano chords, as we call it, we take it as F, A, C, A, C, F, and CFA. These are our piano inversions for each triad. Each triad has three inversions. In your left hand, however, you could write the same equation in a circle, but you could move in the counterclockwise direction as you're counting the notes. So what was once FAC in the right hand, which would be a clockwise movement, will now be FCA in the left hand. And that's your deep voicing, or the spread voicing. Very rich sound. So actually, you'll even have the inversions, right? So let's try and conclude this lesson with a nice sounding chord progression for you guys to practice. So we are in the key of F major, 1 major, 6 minor, very common movement, 2 minor, 5 major, which is the dominant, going back to the tonic. Let's do that again. F major, D minor next, D minor, G minor, and we end on C major. Let's do that again. D minor, G minor, C major, back to. And now you can actually play out a melody. So try to practice improvising over a melody, over this chord progression. The chord progression is 1, 6, 2, 5, which we are trying to play in spread voicing. And there are two patterns you could consider playing in your left hand. Simple eighth notes, 1 and 2 and 1 and 2. And then we can even do in sixes, 2 and 3, and or in a 3/4 environment, 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. I like this as well. If you're unfamiliar with the right hand, if it's taking you some time, focus on maybe singing while you navigate through the left hand challenge, right? So you could do something like la da 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 da. Okay, so let's recap the lesson, everyone. We've looked at spread voicing, which is a very clean way of playing chords in the left hand, adding also a dimension of richness and warmth and uniqueness and colorfulness and all these other fancy adjectives to the sound. So all you do is take the root, don't play the third inside the fifth, play the third outside the fifth. So the voicing ordering will be one, perfect fifth, major third played up, which is the tenth, or else minor tenth or the minor third played up in the instance of the minor chord. So practice it on a few other chords, maybe C major, C, G, E, minor. And the trick to do this and achieve that continuity between the sound, if you will be to use the sustain pedal. You can afford to leave your finger but hold the pedal. But the challenge here is you need to lift it and then get to the next chord. You can't keep holding it, otherwise it's going to sound very muddy. Right, guys? So again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel School of Music. If you found the lesson useful, please like the video, subscribe, and share it with all your musician friends. And also leave us a comment if you'd like to learn anything in particular. Cheers.